In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make your videos easier to watch online. Making a video file size is smaller can help your audience with a smoother viewing experience, especially if they're watching your videos on a mobile device. Hi, Mark from Pocket Video School. And if this is your first time here, why don't you subscribe to my YouTube channel to make sure that you don't miss out on any tips, tricks, techniques and strategies that I use to make video, and especially using my smartphone. Now, we've all experienced that frustrating video issue where you wait for ages and ages for a video to play without stuttering on your computer, tablet or mobile phone. As more and more videos are now in HD, we expect the viewing experience to match the actual quality. But if it doesn't play smoothly, we get fed up and we move on to something else, which is the last thing we want as business owners who are using video to educate and entertain their viewers. By reducing the size of the video files that we upload to our websites and video sharing platforms, we can speed up the time it actually takes to get the file uploaded and make it a much smoother experience for our viewers. And if you do it correctly, there will be very little noticeable difference in the actual quality of the video. So using a free tool, I'm going to walk you through the process that I use to compress my video files, to speed up my workflow and make my videos play more efficiently for my viewers. So the first thing you need to do is go across to a website called handbrake.fr. And just click the download button if you're using it for Windows. It's also available for Mac and Linux as well. Now, once you've installed it and you've opened up the application, then the first thing you need to do is decide which file it is that you actually want to compress. So the one I'm going to use is this Action Movie FX. And as you can see, if I just go to properties, file size was 295 megabytes. So I'm going to open that in Handbrake. Now, across on the right hand side, you'll see you've got a whole load of presets here, which in the current version, there's a tremendous amount of different ones. So what I would recommend doing is scrolling down to the bottom and using the normal legacy setting. Then you have to choose the destination and the file name of where you want to save it. So I'm going to put Action Movie FX _ compressed, and I'm going to save it in the same folder so we can make the comparison between the two, and making sure that the file extension is MP4. Save that. The next thing we need to do is click this checkbox that says web optimized. Now, what that means is, without getting into too many technical details, but an MP4, when you upload that natively to your website, for instance, and you weren't using something like YouTube, what happens is MP4, the header information to tell the video to play is actually at the end, just the way that this particular file extension MP4 works. So what would happen is, if you were just uploading it to your website, then it would have to download the whole of the file before it actually started playing. And what you want to do obviously is move that header information to the front of the file, so that when it starts to download, then it tells the video to start playing as it's progressively downloading. So yeah, I know that's quite technical, but that's the basic interpretation of it. Is just web optimized, it makes it what they call fast start enabled. So it moves the header information to the beginning so that it'll start playing before it's completed downloading, which is exactly what you need when you're doing anything online. The next thing you need to do is just make sure that the video file size is correct. Now, this was a 720p, so HD video. If you click into the video files, this is where you would make sure that H.264 was the correct codec. Now, why H.264? Well, that's the best compression codec to use, especially for playing on the web. Now, there is a new H.265, which reduces the file sizes even more, but unfortunately, the likes of YouTube don't support that codec yet. And because it's so new. I think it probably will come in the future, but at the moment just stick to H.264, which is the best compression for the best quality. Leave everything variable frame rate, just leave that as it is. Quality, constant quality, leave that at 20. Now if you look at this, it does tell you the suggested values are between 18 and 20. Now what I would say is just change this to 18, because what happens is when you upload to YouTube, it does compress it slightly using their own codec. So the higher quality that you can send it, the better. Audio, I would leave the audio as it is, AAC and in stereo. Subtitles, not necessary, and chapters, not necessary. So the next thing to do is just press start. And then the software itself has a progress bar down on the bottom left hand corner, and it'll run through the compression process. So rather than keep you hanging here, I'm going to speed this process up so you can see what the file size looks like. Okay, so Handbrake's finished doing its thing now. So I'm going to open up the folder where I saved it, and here's the original, which was 295 meg, and this is the compressed version that Handbrake's done for me, and this is 44.1 megabytes. Now that's quite a substantial difference. It's about a fifth of the size of the original, if not more. So that would obviously upload a hell of a lot quicker if I was using YouTube or if I was uploading it to my website. And that also means that on playback, it's going to play a hell of a lot quicker because there isn't as much information to actually download. So what I'll do is I'll put the two videos side by side and you can see if there's any degradation in the actual quality. Hi everyone, Mark from pocketvideoschool.com here. And a few people have asked me recently, who've seen the intro video I did for my website, how I managed to create the little animation of the boulder crushing Chris.
Well, I hope you found that really useful. So go and download Handbrake now and start compressing those videos and speeding up your upload times and your workflow and the experience for your viewers as well. If you haven't already, don't forget, subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's a link at the bottom there. And I've also linked up here to another one of my video tutorials. See you again next week.